It's me, Norbert again. Now we're gonna talk about the structure report, and that means a lot of calculations. The foundation for a safe operation of a temporary demountable structure is good planning, and the static calculation plays a decisive role. But what is this calculation about? What must it contain, and who is allowed to do it? The static calculation is comprised of the following verifications: analysis of the ultimate limit, analysis of the serviceability limit, and the safety against overturning, sliding, and uplifting. First of all, let's talk about the ultimate limit. A structure is considered sufficiently strong if the internal strength can withstand the external forces. For example, if the external influence is in equilibrium with the internal reaction. The term serviceability is usually understood to mean the avoidance of excessive deformations that restrict the use of a structure. With multi-level exhibition stands, for example, this would mean the limitation of deflection for the upper floors. Deflections that are too large cause discomfort in several respects. On one hand, you feel unsafe when you're underneath the structure. On the other hand, large deformations are often accompanied by vibrations, which are unpleasant for people standing on the upper floors. The third factor is that of positional stability. This means that the building does not slide, overturn, or uplift, for example, due to the wind loads. Stage roofs made of aluminium truss are especially susceptible to uplift, as they are actually a lightweight structure compared to wind loads. Static calculations must always be verifiable. For example, they must be self-contained, complete, and clearly structured. I would like to explain the structure of a structural report using the PA5030, a PA tower from Milos. The calculation must not only be understandable for another engineer who checks the calculation. This means that the statics should be clearly structured and all important information for the user should be easy to find. Therefore, our calculations are usually divided into two chapters. In the first chapter, all important information for operation is clearly and comprehensively summarized. In the second chapter, the mathematical proofs are listed, which are usually only important for the test engineer. Our report begins with the description of the object, which enables an on-site inspector to clearly identify the structure. This includes a description of the structure's functionality and its external dimensions. The next step is general information for the user. This includes such things as the required ballasting, wooden underpinning of the bases, and a rough description of the permissible payloads. The load assumptions are also an important point that should be clearly described for the user. This is the only way to clearly identify the payloads and wind loads the system is designed for. In the second part of the calculation, the mathematical proofs are listed, which are usually only understandable for engineers. A static calculation is usually checked by another engineer, especially if the object has a certain size. The so-called dual control principle applies here. Now the question remains about who is allowed to prepare a static calculation. The answer depends on where the structure will be located, as each country around the world has different rules and regulations. A basic requirement is certainly a proper university degree, such as a civil engineer or mechanical engineer. Since engineers also assume a high degree of responsibility with every calculation that bears their signature, they should at least have a sufficiently high liability insurance policy to insure themselves against claims.